Hello students, so here we are with the question 4th of the exercise 1.1 for the chapter real numbers. So the question 4th is use Euclid's division lemma to show that the square of any positive integer is either of the form 3m or 3m plus 1 for some integer m. And the hint has been provided that let x be any positive integer, then it is of the form 3q, 3q plus 1 or 3q plus 2. Now, square each of these and show that they can be rewritten in the form 3m or 3m plus 1. So, we know the Euclid's division algorithm says A is equals to BQ plus R. Right, where A and B are some integers such that A is greater than B. Now, what this lemma means that if we divide the number A with the number B, then Q is being obtained as a quotient and R is being obtained as a remainder. And the values which a variable R can take, or we can say the integer R can take, is R can be greater than or equal to 0 but less than B, that is divisor. Now suppose in this case B is equals to 3. So then A will be equal to 3q plus r. Now in this very case B is equal to 3, so the range of the values which r can take is greater than or equal to 0 but less than 3, means the set of the value which r can take is 0, 1, 2. Right, now substituting each value of r in this one by one. So let me first substitute A is equals to 3q plus r, where r is equals to 0. So this will be equal to 3q, right? Now substitute the value of r is equals to 1, then A will be equal to 3q plus 1. And if I substitute the value of r to be 2, then A will be equal to 3q plus 2. So let me write this in the center. So here A will be equal to 3q plus 1, 3q and 3q plus 2 by using the three values of R. Now in the question it's been asked to square positive integer. So starting with the A is equal to 3q, on squaring both the sides, so I'll be getting A squared is equals to 3q squared. Or I can write it as A square is equals to 9q square, which can also be written as 3 into 3q square. And we know q is some integer, and the square of any integer is an integer which when multiplied with 3, and we know 3 is an integer, this term will definitely be an integer. Let's say this be an integer m. So I can write A square is equals to 3m, right? Now coming to the second one, here A is equals to 3q plus 1. Again squaring on both the sides, here A square will be equal to 3q plus 1 whole square. And we know that here we can easily apply the identity, that is A plus B whole square, which is equal to A square plus B square plus 2ab, where A in this case is 2q, 3q. And what is B? B is 1. So from here, A square will be equal to 9q square plus 6q plus 1. Now if I take 3 common from the first and the second term, so in the bracket I'll be left with 3q square plus 2q and plus 1 for the third term. Now, if I see this bracket terms, then both the terms are integers and the addition of two integers is an integer. So, let me write this integer be m. So, here A square will be equal to 3m plus 1. Right. Now, coming to the third one, here the A is equals to 3q plus 2. Now, squaring on both the sides, here A square will be equal to 3q plus 2 whole square. Now again applying the identity, this will be equal to 9q square plus 12q plus 4. That is using the identity a plus b whole square. This will be equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab, where a is equals to 3q and b is equals to 2. I can also write the term 4 as 3 plus 1. So this whole term will be equal to 9q square plus 12q plus 3 plus 1. Now if I take 3 common from the first three terms, so here in the bracket I'll be left with 3q square plus 4q plus 1 and then plus 1 for the fourth term, right? As we can see in the bracket, the terms involved are integers, because q is an integer, 3 is an integer, 4 is an integer, 1 is also an integer, and the arithmetic addition, multiplication and subtraction when applied over an integer will result into some another integer. Let's say this integer be m. So I can write this as 3m plus 1. So here a square comes out to be 3m plus 1. So if I see all the three forms, so two forms are possible for a square. What are those forms? Either a square can be equal to 3m or 3m plus 1. So these are the two possible forms when square any positive integer. Right. So let's verify whether the result being obtained is true or no. So the forms are 3m and 3m plus 1. Let's say a is equals to 8. Then on squaring a, that is 8 square is equal to 64, which is equal to 63 plus 1. And we know 63 can also be written as 3 into 21 plus 1. If I substitute in place of 21 a variable m, so this will be 3m plus 1, where m is equals to 21. Means if a is equals to 8, then on squaring the form it take is 3m plus 1. Now let's take another variable, say a is equals to 11. Then on squaring 11 square is equals to 121, which can also be written as 120 plus 1. And we know 120 is a multiple of 3, because 120 is equals to 3 into 40 plus 1, which can be written as 3m plus 1, where m is equals to 40. Like this, we can take any positive integer value for the variable a, or we can say for an integer a, and on squaring a, the number which will be taking the form is either 3m or 3m plus 1. Means only two possible forms are there on squaring the positive integer. What are those? 3m or 3m plus 1. Not any other form can be obtained for the positive integer on squaring. And provided with the condition that we have assumed here b value to be 3, then only these two forms are possible. So this was about the question 4th of exercise 1.1. I hope this question is clear to all of you.